Okay, so I'm doing this video to explain the part numbers for the other video that I do to replace the ABS module, or to fix the ABS module for a 4Runner and another Toyota 4Runner or another car that have the same system. These one are the brushes. And the part number they describe, this is the part number, and they describe the measurements for the parts. Yeah. And see, you can take a caliper, you can take the measurements in your part, in your motor, your electrical motor, and compare with this part number. And this one is the bearing. Yeah, I just replace the rear bearing, yeah, because I have to remove it. When you remove it, you damage, and I change this and this one are the part number. And you can take the measurements with a caliper, the external diameter, the internal diameter, and this the width, and compare with your part. And this one is the commutator. This one is the commutator, yeah. And this one is the part number, and this one is 12 poles. It's 12 thin like this. These ones. See, you can, this one is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, and 12. Yeah, so it's gonna be 12 parts of this one. This one, the 22 is the external diameter, this diameter. The external diameter. And 18 is the length, this measurement, the length. Yeah. Before, I used one that have 16, but I didn't find that anymore, and I change for this one, 18. This one is better, a little bit better, because it's longer and it's easier to locate it when you replace it, and to bend these parts and to hook up the wiring in these parts. And this six is the internal diameter, this one. This internal diameter is 6 millimeter. The other one have 8 millimeter, before have 8 millimeter, and you have to open it to 9 millimeter normally. But you have to make sure, and you can take the measurement with a caliper and compare with your parts, okay? Make sure before you order any parts, you have to make the comparison with these measurements. Yeah, especially for this part, because the brushes, see, are a little bit bigger. You can sand it, yeah, and shape it. You can shape it, the length. You can shape the weight with a sandpaper. You just sand it like this, like that, and like that, and you can shape it to the measurement that fit with your part. Yeah, especially I think a little bit the weight should be this one and this one, yeah, this part and the length, yeah, all that you can shape it. See, it doesn't fit properly in your part, or it's too tight. And the bearing for sure is gonna be this one. Yeah, it's gonna be this one. I do this job like 6-8 times, I don't remember. And I apologize, because the video that I do first was a very bad video, very poor quality. And the second one, I make some mistake because I do alone. I don't have a helper to do the video. And that's why when I show up the part numbers, he didn't show up too so much well. And is that why I'm doing this video with my phone? With my phone to be more explicit in this information that is gonna help you guys, okay? Anyways, see, if you wanna get more information, you can read the comments in the video. There are a lot of information there, and is there, my phone number is there too. So you wanna text me or call me by WhatsApp or directly in the phone line. No problem. I'm gonna help you, and I'm gonna try to help as much as I can. Because I know that this one is a very expensive part, and you can save a lot of money, because this part is gonna cost less than $100. Yeah, this one is like $20. This one is like each one at $2, something like that, $2 or $3 each one. And this one, I don't remember how much, but this is the same thing, like it's no more than $10, this couple of things. And you're gonna save a lot of money buying this one, and it's not that difficult to do it. Just take care, don't damage the wiring in the commutator when you're hooking up this one. You're hooking up, and you have to bend this one, straight this one a little bit, bend it in this way. To hook it up the wiring here, and when you drill this one, it should be with a 9mm, 9mm drill. Don't worry about to put glue or something there; it's not necessary, because the wiring is enough holding for this thing that doesn't move. I tell you, I fixed like 8 units so far, and I don't have any problem so far with this thing. And never the customer return to do a complaint with this when I fix this one. Okay, I think it's everything for now.